What do you mean women and children?
It's not women and children that get saved.
You know the Bible when it speaks.
So wait, there are 144,000 Israelites that get saved.
No Israelites.
But you in Revelation 7.
No. Revelation 7 are those who were they married. We know that most of them married.
They're Jews, right?
Yes.
Men.
Yeah, and men,
right,
of course.
Okay,
and
so let's go now. Revelation 14. Who are they?
No, they are separate.
Are those men?
Yeah, it says men. They're not defined.
Okay, so you got two elect, right? And they're both men. So where's the women and children?
Why are you asking me that?
Of course I won't ask you because it's your doctrine.
It's something we read. You do not put the question.
Of course I'm gonna ask you. If you're preaching to me, I'm gonna ask you questions.
Don't put words. Don't add to the Bible.
I'm not adding to nothing.
You don't need me to add.
I'm putting the two together.
You don't need me to add to the Bible.
But you said
let's take one thing.
But you said that the Jews in Revelation 7 are all men, right? Then you said, now listen, but that's what you said. I'm not disputing with you.
You're right.
Revelation 7, they're men. Those are men.
So why are you putting
it
to me? Where are the women? Why are you putting that to me then?
Yeah, because this is your doctrine. This is your doctrine. So I'm going to ask.
No, you can't give me a doctrine.
This is
my own.
This is Prophet Ezekiel chapter 34, verse 31. And ye my flock, the flock of my pasture, are men. And I am your God, saith the Lord God.
Right, so the flock of his pasture, 144,000 of chapter 7, those are all men.
Right.
And that's the same guys that are spoken of in Revelation 14. It's not difficult to understand that.
Anyway, my question to you is this.
Where are the women and children?
I don't know.
So how the hell are they gonna inherit the earth and they don't have no women and children?
No, this question you don't need to ask me because I didn't write that.
Yeah, but
you
see,
you're being disingenuous.
No, I'm being genuine.
You read something, it says it's men.
Hold on, do you go to church?
No. Let's not go there. You read something and it says it's a man. Now you are asking me where are the women? You're being disingenuous.
That's simple.
You don't need to ask me.
Why have I asked you that? You mean to talk? Do you have the truth?
If it says men.
Do you have the truth?
If it says men.
Do you have the truth?
No, listen. If it says men, I don't need to question that. If it says women, it's women.
But where are the women?
I don't know.
Then show me. Show me where the women.
Why should I show you?
So is this gonna be men? So how are they gonna have sex?
Who are you not?
So how are they gonna have sex?
Who are you not?
Huh?
Who are you not?
You not speaking. You
not here recording you.
What about
you? Who are they? Are they men or women?
Obviously that's men, isn't it?
So why are you asking me where are the women?
Is there a woman of the elect? Is there any woman that's of the elect? They're of the saints.
Listen.
Are there women of the saints?
It is good to argue on what we know as facts. Well. Yes? You don't go outside the fact.
But that's a part of the fact. That's part of the truth.
No,
where are the women?
No.
In your doctrine. This is your doctrine.
It is not my doctrine.
If it is, you're the one preaching it to me.
Sir.
You're preaching to me that it's just men.
No.
There's no women.
You know, I quote you a verse.
Give me the scriptures where she shall be saved in childbearing.
I quote you a verse in Isaiah. It says, you know. It did not say women. Enoch in Isaiah, and then Christ confirmed that, and then the Revelation confirmed it. You are saying it's my doctrine?
Yeah, but you're the one preaching it though.
I'm not preaching, I'm pointing
you
it
are,
to
yeah,
you.
Yeah. So where do you come from, church? You. Where do you come from? Be honest, man, be honest.
Where do I come from?
You're the one being disingenuous now.
Oh, you are asking me women now.
Where do you come from?
You guys can
where
lie.
Where do you come from? Where do you come from?
It's not important.
Where do you come from?
It's not important.
See, he's the one being disingenuous now.
No.
You're the one being disingenuous.
You want to add to the Bible.
I'm not adding to the Bible. You're the one adding to the Bible.
No, I said men there, and you are asking where are the women. You want me to add to the Bible.
Let me read this. 1 Timothy 2 verse 13. For
just
Adam was first
Paul
born,
and Paul,
then
Paul
Eve.
Back and forth.
And
Paul.
Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived was in the transgression.
See.
Notwithstanding, she shall be saved in childbearing.
Yeah.
So women are going to get saved.
Without childbearing.
But women are going to be saved.
Without childbearing.
But
it says,
but women are going to get saved.
This
but where's the woman?
The woman.
But you said that the Revelation 7 on all men and Revelation 14 on all men. But the scripture says that there's women that's going to be saved.
The Pope wrote this for you.
So where's the woman?
I'm saying the Pope wrote that for
you. But where's the woman?
Yeah, the Pope.
Huh?
The Roman Church.
So you don't believe that?
Wrote that for you.
So you don't believe that?
No.
So you don't believe that?
Women don't have to be childbearing before they are saved. It's nonsense.
So where it says, notwithstanding, she shall be saved in childbearing if they continue in faith. So they're gonna have faith.
In childbearing.
No women are gonna have faith.
No, in childbearing. That's the
point.
No,
and it says if.
Yeah.
If. Because a woman can give birth, but if she don't have faith. But if it says if they continue in faith.
No, the first point is what the question.
Like childbearing.
Yeah.
But it says if they continue in faith.
You see, you're mixing
and charity, holiness,
you can lie, you see,
and sobriety.
You don't like the truth.
So no, you don't like the truth.
You don't like the truth. First of all, First of all, it says childbearing.
Yeah.
It's together. You have to.
Listen. A woman can get childbearing.
Yes.
Women, but she could be wicked. She could be wicked.
Yes. So
she could be committing adultery.
So
she might give birth, but then she's sleeping with other men.
Don't run ahead of this. I'm saying what you just read, it says a woman can be saved through childbearing.
But if
it didn't say and.
It said if.
Okay. If.
So
that's after the childbearing.
Right. If she continues in faith.
So the question is, if that woman
If
that woman doesn't give birth to
he's trying to twist it. Yeah, he's trying to twist it. You are twisting
that,
it, man.
Cannot be from God.
Let me read it again. Notwithstanding, she shall be saved in childbearing. If they continue in faith,
I'm saying,
and charity,
that is
and holiness, and sobriety, because any wicked woman
can
give birth, man. That doesn't mean she's going to be saved just for giving birth. She's got to have faith. She's got to be in order with how the scriptures say a woman is supposed to be.
So
women are going to be saved. But according to you, no women are going to be saved.
No, I didn't say that.
But yes, what you're preaching though.
What did I say?
You said every man of the elect in Revelation 7 and 14 are all men. So where's the woman? Where did the woman
come
from?
Did I say women?
But I'm asking you, where's the woman? Where's the woman? You don't know.
Did
they say you don't know.
Is it written as women? That's
men.
The question I'm asking you.
It's written as men.
So why are you asking me
but now,
something
I'm
which is
asked,
not written?
I'm asking you because I don't know. But say if I'm an ignorant guy. If I'm an ignorant guy and I don't know the truth, I'm coming to you. You know better than me. You know the truth. I'm asking, where are women going to be saved?
Read
so show
7, verse 12.
Get that.
So Revelation 7 and 12, saying, Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving.
Start from 10,
7 and 10, and cried with a loud voice, saying, salvation unto our power, which sitteth upon the throne and upon the Lamb.
And
you talk about all nations.
Verse 9, and after this I beheld, lo, a great multitude, which no man could number, of all nations and kindreds and people and tongues, stood before the throne, before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palms in their hands.
Right.
So that's where the women are.
Okay, you're right.
So why are you being disingenuous?
No, because I'm asking you.
See,
You don't need to be.
The Lord knows I'm not guessing.
Okay.
I don't guess.
All right. So you're right.
I thought you know, but you're not being fair. That's
but I do know. I want to see if you knew.
Anyway, the point I made, I don't have a doctrine.
Where do you come from?
There's no point to have doctrine. No, doctrine deceives. Yeah? What is good to know is knowing what you have, one has to do to be saved.
You need to listen to us.
No.
You need to listen to us, man.
Christ said.
You need to humble down and listen to us. That's what you need to do to be saved, man.
Christ said it.
Hey, but yo, but then that means you're going to be destroyed, man. You're going
to
be destroyed, man.
Listen. A man came to Christ and said, "What shall I do to have eternal life?"
What did he say? What did
Christ said, listen, he didn't say go to church, he didn't say go to, you know, the temple, go to do whatever, however. He says, obey the Ten Commandments. That's it.
But that ain't it, man. That means I can be a faggot now.
If you're a faggot, are you obeying the Ten Commandments?
Well, it doesn't say that I can't be a faggot in the Ten Commandments.
Really?
It doesn't say in the Ten Commandments.
Are you serious?
Yeah, read it for yourself.
I don't think it's
a Ten Commandments. When it says you should not covet, what does it mean?
Another neighbor's property or his wife.
Yes, does it say your neighbor's boyfriend?
What are you talking about?
Faggot?
I said, listen, there's no, in the Ten Commandments, faggot really is just a piece of wood burned. That's what it really means. But it became later known as a word to describe homosexuals.
Exactly. So when the Bible says, do not covet your neighbor's wife,
right,
it's clearly stated
that's
that
adultery. That's adultery.
No.
That is adultery.
A neighbor has a wife.
And you're trying to take that man's wife. Exactly. That's called adultery.
And what do we know about marriage in the Bible?
That's between a man and his wife.
So why are you talking about faggot and the mistake?
Yeah, because you're saying that if you follow the Ten Commandments.
Yes.
Now, part of the Ten Commandments, it doesn't say anywhere in the Ten Commandments,
yeah,
thou shalt not be a sodomite. It doesn't say that.
That means I can
keep the Ten Commandments and still be a homosexual.
No.
What?
Because.
But you said that's only, I only have to keep the Ten Commandments.
The Ten Commandments states, that do not covet your neighbor's wife.
That's what they mean.
Wait, and neighbor's wife, meaning it comes from the principle of marriage, right? So, and the principle of marriage in the Bible is between man and woman. So, it still talk about man and woman, marriage, not a faggot. So, I don't know where you...
Let me read this. It says, 1 Timothy 4, verse 16.
My brother, I don't follow Paul.
Take heed unto that.
I don't follow Paul.
Who do you follow?
I follow Christ.
And what did Paul say? He said, be ye followers of me.
No,
as I am a follower of Hamashiach.
I tell you, this is the problem we have. Yeah? Everybody quote Paul and leave what
first,
I said.
Okay, 1 Corinthians chapter 11,
no,
verse 1.
Going on and on.
Be ye followers of me. Even as I also am of
what did Christ
says Christ.
What did Christ say?
Was Paul a follower of Christ?
No. What did Christ say?
Was Paul a follower of Christ?
Christ says, follow me.
Right, yeah.
He didn't say
was Paul a follower
Paul.
Of Christ?
No.
He wasn't.
Listen.
So he wasn't?
No, I didn't say that.
Was he or yes or no?
I didn't say that.
Was he yes or no?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? The scriptures told you.
Because Christ said we should look up to him, not to anybody.
Yeah, but men,
and so therefore,
the Lord set up teachers.
No.
Whoever. The Lord set up teachers, man.
And he didn't say we should follow the teachers.
But
he said we should obey.
Wasn't we taught by somebody? Wasn't we taught by someone?
My brother.
Yes or no?
You want to listen to
was
us?
You taught by someone? Was you taught by someone?
No, listen.
Was you taught
if
by someone?
I am
yes
taught,
or no?
I don't follow that
was
person.
Was you taught by someone? Yes or no?
Who?
Was you taught by someone? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, so you followed a man?
No.
To get what you learned from?
No.
Of course, you must have followed him. He was taught you and you were sitting there nodding your head, taking down notes.
No, I'm not.
You was following
I'm not
him.
A robot.
You was his disciple.
I still raise him.
You was his disciple.
I'm the disciple.
You was his
Christ.
Disciple. No, you was the disciple of that guy that
of
you followed.
Christ. No,
whoever
I don't follow
taught
anybody.
You, whoever taught you, you was his disciple.
You are mixing things.
And you learn from him.
My brother,
that the disciples, the 12
wait,
disciples,
wait a second.
They learn from the Lord.
Wait
right?
a second. I'm saying, Christ gave a command that go into the world,
right,
preach the gospel, right, and whoever believe, baptize them in the name of the Father, right?
Yeah.
Now, if Christ says that, he says, make disciples for
right.
who? For himself.
Right.
If you become a disciple, you represent Christ.
Right.
Not Paul,
right.
not Matthew, not Peter,
okay.
nobody.
But
now, listen, if Christ says we should follow him,
right.
and another person says I should follow him,
right.
a man.
But now, okay, now listen now, now listen now, person. Listen now, listen now. Say it now. When the Lord was here 2,000 years ago, we all followed him, right? Yeah, because he was here.
Yeah.
But now, listen. Please, just wait. Just wait.
I have to go. No, I have to go.
Okay. You know, all right, but now listen. It says that the Lord left, right? Mm-hmm. The Lord left. So when the Lord went and sat on the right hand side
of them, almost died.
So who was left? The apostles.
Yeah, but he said you send the Comforter.
Yeah.
Which is basically this.
Not only to who?
It's truth.
Is it the Comforter is in you as well, right?
Huh?
The Comforter is in with you.
Yes.
Yeah. So the Comforter would teach you all things. Yeah.
Yeah,
that's it.
Okay, but that's the spirit. That's the spirit of Yahweh.
For example, if somebody is preaching to me, and the Comforter in me would direct me. Listen.
Yes, please.
The Comforter will give me the judgment whether that preaching is of God or not. And that Comforter is the teacher. Is the one that guides me to follow Christ. Don't follow Paul. I don't.
Yeah, but Moses set up men. So basically, everything that Paul read, you don't read that.
I don't put emphasis on it than I compared to Christ.
So you don't follow nothing that Paul read.
No.
So you're basically saying that Paul, the Most High, wasn't dealing with Paul.
I didn't say that.
But then what was Paul then?
Was
Paul a man of God?
I use what
was Paul
Christ,
a man of God?
I use what Christ said as my yardstick of my life.
Was Paul a man of the Most High?
I don't know.
Man, you can't say that.
Right,
you can't. That's blasphemy. Did not the Lord teach Paul?
Do I know? I don't.
That means you don't know.
Because
when Paul told you that the Lord,
when Paul was writing this, I wasn't there.
Then it says, Paul fell off the horse. Paul fell off the horse.
Then he saw the Lord. He saw him.
Ah,
and then he said, and he spoke unto him in the Hebrew tongue.
Yeah.
He says, why is it hard? It's too hard for you to kick against the prince.
Nah, let me ask you. Did the people also hear the voice?
Huh? Yeah, there was. But they didn't see it. Only Paul saw it.
And in another verse, he says they heard the voice. Yeah? So first, they didn't hear the voice. And then he heard the voice.
Wait, when did they say that?
Have you read Acts?
No,
I wouldn't say
that.
No, read Acts again. You see that Paul contradicts himself.
We didn't say that.
See, you guys here.
Verse 13, at midday, O king, I saw in the way a light from heaven above the brightness of the sun shining round about me and them which journeyed with me. All right? And when we were all fallen to the earth, I heard a voice speaking unto me and saying in the Hebrew tongue, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? It is hard for thee to kick against the prince. And I said, who art thou, Lord? And he said, I am Yahweh Shai, whom thou persecutest. And it goes on.
Is that the only place he spoke about that story?
Well, you got something?
I have these verses of faith, but you know what?
Yeah, this is Acts chapter 9,
yeah.
Verse 3. And as he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly there shined round about him a light from heaven. And he fell to the earth and heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he said, Who art thou, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Yahweh Shai, whom thou persecutest. It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks. Exactly. So he trembling and astonished said, Lord, what would thou have me to do? And the Lord said unto him, Arise and go into the city, and it shall be told thee what thou must do. And the men which journeyed with him stood speechless, hearing a voice, but seeing no man. Okay.
Compare with that one. You see the contradiction there?
Yeah, no, he's just talking about himself.
No. Where you say they heard a voice?
He didn't say that.
Read it again.
Acts 26:13. At midday, O king, I saw in the way a light from heaven, above the brightness of the sun, shining round about me, and them which journeyed with me. And when we were all fallen to the earth, I heard a voice speaking unto me and saying in the Hebrew tongue, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks. Yeah, that's it. Yeah. And I said, Who art thou, Lord? And he said, I am Yahweh Shai, thou persecutest. But rise and stand upon thy feet, for I have appeared unto thee for this purpose, to make thee a minister and a witness both of those things which thou hast seen and of those things in the which I will appear unto thee, delivering thee from the people and from the Gentiles unto whom now I send thee, to open their eyes and to turn them from darkness to light, and from the power of Satan unto the Most High, that they may receive forgiveness of sins and inheritance among them which are sanctified by faith that is in me. Whereupon, O King Agrippa, I was not disobedient unto heavenly vision. Yeah, that's it, man.
What's your point? Here he says they heard the voice.
Right.
Where he says they saw the light.
No, they didn't say that. They said they were just falling to the earth. That's it.
But here, therefore,
yeah. He's just expounding more. It doesn't mean that they didn't hear it.
No.
Paul never said that they didn't hear it.
No. See,
he didn't say that. That's what you're saying.
No, I'm not.
What point did you want to make?
What's your point anyway?
What point did you want to make?
What point I'm making?
Yeah.
I'm saying here.
Because he's basically saying that we shouldn't follow Paul. And he's trying to say that.
That's
what the Lord said about Paul, yeah?
Not only that. What are you reading?
Hold on. These are Acts 9 and 11. Yeah. And the Lord said unto him, Arise and go into the streets, which is called Straight, and inquire in the house of Judas for one called Saul of Tarsus. For behold, he prayeth, and have seen in a vision a man named Ananias coming in and putting his hand on him that he might receive his sight. Then Ananias answered, Lord, I have heard by many of this man how much evil he hath done to the saints at Jerusalem, and here he hath authority from the chief priests to bind all that call upon thy name. But the Lord said unto him, Go thy way, for he is a chosen vessel unto me to bear my name before the Gentiles and kings and the children of Israel. For I will show him how great things he must suffer for my name's sake.
Alright. He must suffer for my name's sake. So I'm showing you Paul was a man of the Lord, man.
A chosen vessel.
A chosen vessel. So when Paul is speaking, he's telling you the things that pertain unto the Most High, man. Like prophets. When prophets was prophesying, people said, I ain't gonna listen to you, I'm just gonna listen to God.
Romans chapter
2. No, listen to what I'm saying, man. I'm trying to tell you that, listen, when the prophets was on the scene, no one listened to the prophets, just like how you're saying, we shouldn't listen to Paul. Paul was a prophet. You're trying to say that we shouldn't listen to Paul?
Let's read something before
I just, what?
Chapter 13, verse 9.
Romans 13,
verse 9. For this thou shalt not commit adultery, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not bear false witness, thou shalt not covet. If there be any other commandment, is briefly comprehended in the same, namely, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
That's what he says.
What's the point again?
You said a lot of things are off. You're completely off. You're Yoruba, right? Go on, Vanille, Shanti.
So 1 Corinthians 14 and 37. If any man thinks himself to be a prophet or spiritual, let him acknowledge that the things that are right unto you are the commandments of the Lord.
Read that again.
If any man,
listen.
Well, if any man thinks himself to be a prophet or spiritual,
so you believe yourself to be spiritual, right? Well,
let him acknowledge that.
Let him acknowledge
that the things that are right unto you,
the things that are right unto you,
are the commandments of the Lord.
Are the commandments of the Lord.
But if any man be ignorant, let him be ignorant.
So we have to let him be ignorant.
We have to let you be ignorant, man. Because you don't want to acknowledge them.
Did Peter, the head disciple, accept Paul or not?
Sorry?
Did Peter, the head disciple, accept Paul or not?
Peter,
the head disciple, chosen by Christ. Did he accept Paul or not? Even though they didn't teach him.
Peter didn't teach him, Barnabas didn't teach him. But did they acknowledge Paul?
You see the progress. Who Paul himself said he received the gospel from the source, which is from the disciple.
Right. You know, he got it from the Lord.
No, he said from the disciple.
He didn't get it from the disciple.
Oh.
He made the disciples after 3 years.
Sorry?
He met the disciples after 3 years.
He said...
So he didn't get... He wasn't taught by the disciples.
He received the gospel from the disciples.
Where did it say that? Show me where it says that.
Oh my
goodness. Yeah, I guarantee you're not going to find it. It doesn't say that. He was taught by the Lord.
So you don't believe that he received from the disciples?
He was not a follower of Peter or any of them. He wasn't disciplined. He wasn't a disciple of them. He wasn't taught by the 12 apostles. Remember, he was murdering. He was killing the elect, man. He was killing the saints. All right. He was a murderer. Following Peter or any of them, the Lord knocked him off the horse and said, "Listen, man, you're gonna be one of my chosen vessels. I'm gonna show you the gospel. You're gonna teach."
I think it's Acts chapter 15 or so, when Paul has to go to Jerusalem and receive interpretation and direction from them, right?
They went to dispute a matter.
He didn't receive the gospel.
So what was the instruction given to him?
They told him, listen, shave your head. To show them that you keep the laws also. It was just a commandment. They didn't train him in anything.
Sir, please. Then they want agreement on an issue.
Yeah.
And they gave instruction to them and they take it with them. Didn't they?
Right.
So what does that mean?
That doesn't mean that Paul sat there and was being taught by them. It's like Paul was there taking notes.
Listen.
If I go, imagine this is Jerusalem and I'm Paul. I come here and you tell me do this and do that. And I say, oh, cool. That doesn't mean you're teaching me. You're just giving me a commandment. You're just telling me do this or do that. It's an order. You're ordering me to do something. And I say, okay. It doesn't mean that you're teaching me. The apostles, the head apostle, Peter, and the disciples didn't teach Paul. Paul was never taught by them. So you're, So your whole point you're trying to make is that you don't follow Paul, you don't listen to Paul. So basically all the epistles he writ was all bullshit basically. That's basically what you're saying.
No, I don't follow anything that says
this is this is Galatians 1:11.
I don't follow whoever
says that. He didn't say that. He said shall we sin that grace may abound? Of course not. He said the Lord publish the law.
What?
Let me get Romans. What?
It's like Galatians 1:11. But I certify you, brethren, that the gospel which was preached of me is not after man.
See, yeah, wait, what? Read that again. Read that.
But I certify you, brethren.
So the Lord, so Paul is certifying you. It's a certain word.
That the gospel which was preached of me is not after man.
The gospel which is preached, the gospel that I'm preaching, I didn't get it from no man.
Okay.
Go ahead.
For I neither received it of man.
So I didn't receive, no man taught me this. I didn't receive this from no man. No man gave me this gospel. Go ahead.
Neither was I taught it.
Neither was I taught it. So he didn't sit down, write notes, listening to what another man had to say. Go ahead.
But by the revelation of Jesus Christ.
Yeah, so he saw the Lord taught him.
Why did you read that?
It's Galatians 1:11-12.
Read Corinthians 15.
Wait, let me add something. This is Romans 3:31. This is what Paul wrote to the Romans. Do we then make void the law through faith? God forbid. Yea, we establish the law.
So
we establish the law.
So when he says the law was nailed to the cross, what does that mean?
Basically, the first covenant.
What first covenant?
First covenant saying, listen, you gotta keep the laws, commandments, and all these blessings that come upon you. But he nailed that to the cross.
What's the covenant?
Basically, faith, man, grace. We're saved through faith. We're justified by faith. By the law? No, because we can't keep the law perfect. We can't keep the laws perfect.
You don't be misleading. I'm saying, when he says the law has been nailed to the cross,
right,
what does that mean? Which law is that?
Well, that's beautiful, because get Galatians, man. It doesn't tell you specific law. Talk about the laws and the commandments.
The commandment,
not a specific one.
When somebody came to Christ and says, what shall I do to inherit the kingdom? He says, follow the commandment. He said, what kind of commandment are you talking about? Yeah, and Christ went specifically to the temple. So what commandment is Paul talking about?
He's talking about the law in its general sense, man. Or 613. The first covenant, man. That's basically what I'm saying. Because listen, we're not justified. We're not justified by the keeping of the law. You understand that? We're not justified by that.
What do you mean it's not justified by that?
Get Galatians, because we're doing a lot of it. No, this bail.
Every time you can deal with something, you change the subject.
I know, I don't like that.
Listen, you just need you to bear with it.
Focusing.
Let me read it. Now listen. Galatians chapter 2, verse 16. Knowing that a man is not justified by the works of the law, but by the faith of Yahweh Shai HaMashiach. Now, the reason why we kept going into slavery as a people is because we couldn't keep the laws perfectly.
So why did Christ say this until
now? Listen, and then we go, then we let you talk. We can't be justified by the law. We can't keep the law perfect. The law is perfect.
Which law?
But it's not talking about which law, the laws in general, man.
You and I know.
The law, the laws are, listen, because you're trying to get into specific. I'm talking about the laws, statutes, and commandments. The laws and commandments, man.
Let's be specific.
He's trying to make it like it's one commandment.
No. Christ was specific.
This
about
guy,
the
man.
Commandment.
Bro, at some point now, we'll let you stop talking, man. We'll tell you can't talk anymore.
You're going to something else.
Sir, we are talking about the law, right?
We dealt with Paul.
Which
law
is
that? You went into the law now.
Paul, I'm saying,
the whole law. The whole law.
Listen, the whole law.
The whole law.
That's why I said, not one.